Hi friends, welcome to Crack JP. We are back with the current affairs series that we are running on our YouTube channel and in the paid course. So this lecture is from the news article from 6th of November to 7th of November 2021, right? For the phase 2 examination, these are very important news article to you to know for, right? And also we bring out to you some news that are in terms seems are not important in terms of objective examination, but very important for your descriptive, right? With the background story, so that you can write and connect things. And this is important for the examination like NABARD, RBI, and SEBI. So let's begin with the first news article. 102 Community Resource Person Enterprise Promotion, CRPEP. So see, this news, you have seen it in the last lecture as well, right? Okay, so this is very important. Startup Village Entrepreneurship Program. So under this scheme, okay, 102 community resource person were certified during 29th October and 4th November 2021. Okay, CRPEPs are trained before they start working with the entrepreneurs. Right, now the important piece of the news is 102 Community Resource Person Enterprise Promotion were certified. Right now, who are these people? They are trained before they start working with the entrepreneurs. Right, so there is a mix of classroom and field training, like we have seen in the last lecture as well. Okay, the training lasts for 56 days. They have to undergo, you know, the field work and as well as the classroom session as well. Okay, so this is very important. Then let's move to the next new article, that is government may ban non-audit service to audit clients. Now see, this is again an important piece of news, but before you read anything, let us understand what or why this news is, you know, important. You have seen, so you know what chartered accountant does, right? So a private limited company has to audit their book, okay, and also they have to keep an account for themselves. Now why they have to audit? For compliance, right? If they are doing right or wrong. So an independent auditor who is a chartered accountant, right? So an independent auditor who is a chartered accountant audit the books. If there is any mistake or if there is any thing that they have missed, so they highlight it before they submit it to the final MCA, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, right? So when these people, means chartered accountant, audit the book of a company and sign it, this does mean that the Ministry of Corporate Affairs believes that everything is right, okay, unless they are caught for being something wrong. So that is altogether a different thing. So the basic duty of a chartered accountant is to sign the book only after an audit that everything is right, okay, and there is nothing compliance with the issue. So there is no you know, no what we can say, up down in taxation or in GST, okay, and everything related to law under the Companies Act 2013. Now what happened? But see, this chartered accountant is also an accountant, right? So what this chartered accountant does, he not only audits the firm, right, as an independent auditor, but he has many small auditors and has a firm registered in his name, right? What he does, he also gives the service as a bookkeeper to that company. Because see, if you maybe see, you are running a company, right, and you are from the non-commerce background. So this does mean that you know nothing about bookkeeping, okay, journal entry, ledger entry, and etc. etc. And the rules of the Companies Act, you don't know, right? So what you do, you hire a firm. Okay, so that firm will say you, okay, I will audit your books at the end of the year and submit it to MCA. And also throughout the year, I will also provide you the services related to bookkeeping, to audit, you know, to filing the GST, you know, to advisory service, everything. Okay, so for you, it's become very easy. Why? Because you have to coordinate with only one person. The person who is your auditor is also the person who is keeping your books. But see how this is arising, how this is a problem related to corporate governance and conflict of interest. Now see. See, every business in the ecosystem is there to make profit, right? So they will try to, you know, find the loopholes. See, every law has a loophole. Okay, so we can, if you can mention it in the comment section, we can design a separate lecture on this. Okay, so where I'm going to explain you a very good story on Karen. So this is a company, you know, that has once blocked Air India planes in the United States because they claim that they owe money from the government of India, only related to, you know, this auditing service. They have found a loophole in the Indian law, and they have used it extensively, and they did it. Okay, so it is, Karen is also there in the recent news, but that is related to private sector, so we'll not discuss that. But yes, if you want to understand the story behind it, let us know in the comment section. We can bring out a lecture on it. Okay, so that will be very interesting and very fun. So now let us understand this thing. So what happened? Every company, you know, find some loopholes and try to save some taxes, try to save some GST. Yes, that is the right thing that they are doing. But if the same person is doing that, so while, you know, keeping the book or while doing the internal audit of the company, he may do some plus minus, okay, which is legally right, you know, but he has found a way to do it. Maybe at some time it's not legally right. Many companies are caught later on, and they have been said that yes, there was a loophole that they have used. But that is altogether a separate thing. So let us understand only the basic part of it. And the same person at the end of the year will audit the books. So will he catch him? Obviously not. But see, if there is a separate chartered accountant who audits, he can catch that. Yes, that here is plus minus. Here is, you know, extra adjustment in the books. This is not right and this should not be done. This is the conflict of interest that government is considering to, you know, separate. I think you have understood it now. So there would be a separate firm or the separate chartered accountant or the separate group of accountants who are going to, you know, do the non-audit services, and there are few, and there will be only independent chartered accountants who will be signing the books for the purpose of audit. So I hope it's now clear. Now, what are non-audit services? Section 144 of the Companies Act says these are the non-audit services. Let's move to the next news article. Fuel tax cut may reduce inflation by 30 bps. Obviously, yes. We don't have to read the entire news. The you know, the logic behind it says it all. Why? Because see, how is the logistic company works? I mean, how is the logistic system of a country works? Not a company, sorry. A country works. By the movement of goods from the place it is manufactured to the place where it is consumed, and how it is done either through the railways or through the roadways, using trucks, using ships. Everywhere fuel is required. What is required? Fuel is required. See, even if it is transferred via train, there has to be some part that it is traveling via road to the end consumer's home, and that is where the fuel plays the important role in everything that we use in our daily life. Even a packet of biscuit, okay, will see a you know, increased profit with this reduction in price of petrol and diesel. Understood? So there is nothing much to explain. You can understand. So by 3.0 percentage point, so we can see a reduction of 0.30 percentage point or 30 bps. So 1% is equal to 100 basis points bps, right? But see, this will not be visible in the recent data, and the data that will be released in the month of December. It takes time, okay? It takes time. Then on the other hand, the measure could cost the union government around 60,000 crore in the remaining 5 months. So see, this is an estimate, okay? So I found in one news article, it is being said as 35,000 crore, and with the same newspaper, with the Business Standard only, okay? In one news article, it's 60,000 crore. On the other news article, it's 35,000 crore. So it's, you cannot actually project, because during the first fiscal of this year we have seen a lockdown, okay, but now the economy is almost open. So whatever work was left out there, people will be doing it in the next from now to from the next 5 months, right? So we cannot really think about the consumption. So below is the tracking index. You can see it in the data, right? So let's move to next news article, that is DoT fixes December 22 deadline. Means Department of Telecom fixes December 22 as deadline for what? For movement of IP version 4 to IP version 6. So you know, if somebody is engineer or technical person who knows about networking, you will understand what is IP4 and IPv6. This is related to internet protocol addresses, right? So June 30, 2022 has been set as the last date. So Department of Telecom first and second roadmap was rolled out in 2010 and 2012. Okay. Old regime IP46, which has limit of 3 billion IP address, whereas IPv6 has unlimited, okay, or the number is more. And this is being done because, you know, the people who are using fixed line internet services or the mobile internet is growing in India, and that's why it is being done. So US has already decided to switch off the IP4 address by 2024, right? So US can do it because population is very less. Let's move to the next news article, that is India to use revenue search to fund welfare scheme. So you see, during the first this month, the revenue collection for the government is high, be it tax collection, be it revenue collection, everything is being high. Okay, so, and also government is set to meet the disinvestment target as well. So once because you see, Air India has been offloaded, right? So every data when it's come to fiscal position of the India looks good. So in the coming month, what government will do with extra revenue is, you know, will continue the welfare fund programs that it is running. So you see in the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan, the free food grains to the poor people is going to end. Let's see if that is being given an extension or not. Okay. And some new scheme may come, because five states is going to poll. Okay. And you see that the petrol and diesel price cut has again, it has hit the government revenue. So what government does is a matter of time to look upon. But more or less, as per the government sources, it would be somewhere around welfare scheme. So the next news article, third biennial update report at COP26. This is very important. Okay. So the scientific advisor to the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change has highlighted that India represents 17% of global population, but its cumulative emissions are only 4%. While current global greenhouse gases emission are only 5%, right? This was the 11th fellowship sharing of views from each of the countries. And India made a presentation on its third biennial report, update report, okay, that was submitted to UNFCCC in Feb 2021. The key highlight of the discussion is India's third BUR was the achievement of 24% reduction in the emission intensity of the GDP over a period of 2005 to 2014. There's a reduction of 24%. This shows India is working towards it, and the significant increase of its solar program. In the last 7 years, India's solar energy capacity has increased 17 times. So what is India's position in the solar in terms of renewable energy? Do mention it in the comment section. So I think last to last lecture, we have discussed that India's solar installed capacity has increased 17 times, right? Even in the Panchamrit, the Prime Minister has increased to 500 gigawatt by 2030, right? Solar installed capacity. With this, we have come to the end of this lecture. This lecture is very short because this is the content from the weekend. So wish you very good luck from the team Cargrade B. Thank you and happy.